Welcome to Wednesday Night Club. It's good to have you here. It's almost like being at Camp Lambeck because we're in the shadow of the Lambeck Chapel, as you can see. So it's wonderful to have you. We're outside the chapel tonight for some reason. So we're in the veil and we're looking at the beauty of God's creation. And what a beautiful night it is to be together for club. And as we begin club, you know how we always start. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Boo.
Boo who?
Oh, don't cry, please. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Etch.
Etch who?
God bless you. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Stop.
Stop who?
Stop what you're doing and listen to this club message that begins with Psalm 121, and it will be read by one of our favorite counselors of all time, Mrs. Kristen Savatt Brown.
I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore.
Thank you, Kristen. And since Kristen's my knock-knock joke echo, I have just one more. Knock-knock.
Who's there?
To.
To who?
You're a teacher, Kristen. You should know. It's to whom. Oh, yes. All right. Well, we're going to think about Psalm 121. And one of the things that Psalm 121 impresses on me is the providence of God. Now, in case that's a word that you're not familiar with, it's kind of a big word. It's just another word for help. And so Psalm 121 tells us where we need to turn for help. The moment we say yes to God and no to the world, all our problems are solved. All our questions are answered. All our troubles are over. Nothing can disturb the tranquility of a soul at peace with God. We Christians are people who don't have accidents, who don't have arguments, who aren't misunderstood, and who always obey our parents, right? If you believe that, you're sadly wrong. To be told we're wrong is usually something embarrassing, kind of humiliating. We run and hide our heads, but there are times when finding out that we are wrong is going to be to our benefit. And that's where Psalm 121 comes in. Eugene Peterson, he's the fellow who translated the Message Bible, you may recall. He tells a story about trying to get his lawnmower blade off his lawnmower so he could sharpen it. He says, I had my biggest wrench and I had it turning as hard as I could to loosen the nut. It wouldn't budge. So I got a 4-foot length of pipe and I put it on the end of the wrench and I tried once again. Still nothing. So I went and I got a big rock and I hit the pipe with the rock and the nut would not budge. It wouldn't move. And then my neighbor came over. He was watching me, what I was trying to do. And he said, you know, I think I had a lawnmower like that once. And if I remember correctly, you turn the nut the other direction to loosen it. Sure enough, he tried it, and the nut loosened right away. And he learned that he was wrong about how he was going about taking the blade off of his lawnmower. And he could have labored and been frustrated all night long with that job, had it not been for his neighbor. Psalm 121 is a voice telling us that perhaps we're going about the Christian life in a way that is wrong. As such, it's a perfect sequel to Psalm 120. You remember Psalm 120 from Monday night, which gets us started on the Christian walk. On Monday, we talked about the confusing and bewildering feelings of alienation and distrust that make us restless, that cause us to turn away from God. But somehow, then, it causes us to seek out God in repentance, which is a turning towards Jesus Christ by faith. But no sooner have we plunged expectantly and enthusiastically into the river of the Christian faith than we get our noses full of water and we begin to choke and we feel like we're going to drown. And we no sooner do we confidently stride out into the road on this walk of faith than we trip and we fall. And we skin our knees and elbows. We look around for help, scanning for someone, for something to help us. I look to the mountains. Does my help come from there? Says Psalm 121. Psalm 121 is the neighbor coming over to tell us that we're doing something wrong and we need to try a different way to do it better. So where do we look? In biblical times, travel by foot was not only difficult, but dangerous. Maybe you remember the parable of the Good Samaritan on the road from Jericho in Luke chapter 10. He was robbed on the road, and he was beaten, and he was left for dead. Getting from one place to another was risky business. We can imagine the psalmist leaving Jericho to travel the road to Jerusalem, looking up the long and treacherous climb ahead of him, wondering, how am I going to get home? Am I going to be safe as I travel on my way home? Where does my help come from? Whichever question you prefer, it leads to the main question, the last one. Where does my help come from? Now, in case you haven't heard, we're in the midst of a pandemic. It's anyone's guess how long it will take for us to recover from this pandemic. We need help. It also happens to be an election year, so candidates are promising that the government will do miracles no matter what we need, if only we vote for them. Don't count on it. If you look to Washington for your help, you'll likely be disappointed. And that's just when we're talking about things like economics and pandemics. Another word for help is the word providence. That's a wonderful word. It simply means to provide something. And this is what the psalmist is looking to God for. We're not having music camp this year at Lambeck because of this deadly virus, but there are plenty of other dangers lurking out there. I read one report that says the oceans are teeming with 10 to 100 times more types of bacteria than previously believed, many of them unknown. U.S., Dutch, and Spanish scientists said they found more than 20,000 types of microbes in a single liter of water. Face it, modern medicine can only do so much for us. But for the moment, let's say that we're able to stay safe and healthy. Where does our help come from when a relationship begins to go south? When a good friend starts running with the wrong crowd, when work becomes a drudgery, when someone we love dies suddenly, when we suffer a crisis of faith and we find it hard to pray, when we wonder, sometimes out loud, does God even care? The big question is, when your life seems to be coming apart at the seams, where do you go for your help? The answer from Psalm 121 is clear. My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Listen, if you don't hear anything else in this club talk, if your help comes from anything or anyone other than the Lord, our God, you are sure to be disappointed. Do you hear what I'm saying? Family, friends, classmates, even your pastor will likely disappoint you at some time, let you down. Only God is ultimately dependable. Only God can reach us in His providence. And remember, another word for providence is the word help. This is why the psalm writer says, "The Lord watches over you. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore." The only mistake we make when illness comes, or when anxiety threatens, or when conflict disturbs our relationships is to conclude that God has either gotten bored looking after us, or God doesn't have the time for us. Could that possibly be true? If we were to ask a gentleman named Tony Dungy, he would give us his answer. Tony Dungy has a long-standing reputation for being a man of integrity and character. When the Indianapolis Colts, nearing the end of the 2005 season, were 13-0 after beating Jacksonville, Tony Dungy's phone rang at 1:30 in the morning. They spoke to the nurse on the other end of the line, informing he and his wife that their son, Jamie, had taken his own life. In his book, Quiet Strength, he says, the next several days were like a fog. We flew to Tampa, where his son was enrolled in college, and began making plans for his funeral. Then Tony Dungy says, my wife and I weren't sure how we'd get through this, but we recognized we were going to have to cling to God's strength and love if we were going to have a chance. God's providence. I can appreciate the strength of this man's character, the depth of his faith. If Tony Dungy were standing here to answer the question from Psalm 121, I'm confident he would say, you want to know where my help comes from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. May the same thing be said of us. Let's pray together. Oh God, there are so many places, so many events, so many circumstances that cause us to look for help. Instead of looking to the mountains, instead of looking in any other place, help us to turn to you. Help us to come to you as the one who is always there to help us, because your providence will care for us, will watch over us, and will be with us in our coming and our going for now and forever. Thank you, Lord, for your help that comes when we need it. Amen.